they stay hot all the time.
Oh.
No cutting.
And I'm not talking about.
No more cutting.
B-R-E-R-E-T-O-N.
E-R-E-T-O-N.
We have plenty of space. Don't turn the moth rest of that, please, leave mine.
I haven't gotten that card back yet.
Card, yeah, before that, the card, are you done uploading or are you still uploading?
I don't need to run it running.
No, I do want it running, I want it running nonstop, seriously. I wanna pick up all the updates. The living of life.
Oh, whoa, see, we didn't know that.
Be well. Tell you how much time is left.
He's doing it.
Teach you.
Okay, we'll be shooting.
I'm gonna head out, thank you.
Truly a pleasure to meet you, but yeah.
Bye.
Bye.
And don't forget to send this,
I just did actually.
Did you already send headshot resume this up?
No.
Do you feel like you?
Do some more stuff to say, I just thought you'd be prompted. Dive in.
I'm not sure if I can like just, I don't really have the same view of it, I don't think it's.
Does it have to be?
Well, it's people in office.
And the government, because the people allow governments to do it.
Exactly.
We have to take responsibility.
Okay, we're rolling, guys.
Quiet on set.
We have to restart.
Quiet on set. We're rolling. Matt.
Hi, I'm Matt.
How high are you?
I'm pretty high.
Good. So why are you so high in life and why should people jump on your bed while you get to save the planet?
People need to understand that it's, you can't put blame on the other people. The only thing that you can do is your own role. Cycle, you talk about being healthy, you talk about non-GMO distribution, and you can do all those things, you can talk about it, but unless you're not eating GMO, you are recycling, or then you're a hypocrite. What the hell? If you're gonna eat GMO, then you're supporting GMO, and you're gonna be putting that money into the people that are gonna be doing more bad things. Well, guess whose fault it is? It's our fault. It's our fault for eating, it's our fault for buying. So, whatever you wanna do, just be healthy, work out, meditate, do whatever it is you need to do to make sure that you have the happiest life possible so everybody else can have a happy life being around you.
Collectively as a whole, how do we disempower those who are driving us down a path of destruction and empower those who are enriching the planet?
Through example. There's only one way really to inspire, and that's by being inspiration.
How do you inspire people?
Being awesome. I inspire people by doing the best I can with my life.
Are you a victim?
I am absolutely not a victim.
So you're not a victim of your society? Bad
no.
Choices by others?
Absolutely not.
So how do you inspire others to have that positive walk through walls, I can do anything?
Understand that circumstances don't matter. And circumstances do not influence your state of being. Your state of being is actually a choice, and your choice is given to you by being healthy.
You think with all the crap we have in our food and our air and our minerals and everything, have we twisted our minds as a society?
Well, for everything that's bad for you, you have a method of detoxing. So if you eat eat a shitty food, you can detox by going to the sauna. Or if you suck in some horrible air, you can probably take some antioxidants and recover from that influence. So at the same time, there are ways to rectify the society's influence on that person's body. If you're not taking them, then it's your own fault that you're not unhealthy. It's not the world's fault. There's ways to counteract every measure that society has given you and imposed on the planet. Stop being mad at the planet. Stop being mad at the government. Start understanding your body and using it in the way that is best for you, and not fucking burning it.
Glass half full, glass half empty.
It's just a glass, who cares?
Okay, that's good. We'll use that for a night. Who gives a shit about the fucking glass? Unless you're recycling it. Recycle that glass, I said. Don't throw it out the window and hit a dog in the head. Jesus Christ. I wasn't prepared for that, actually. Pesticides versus organic.
Don't eat pesticides, you stupid.
What about things you can't pronounce in food?
Look them up. You're stupid. Stop what? Fucking eating things you don't know what they are. Because they're probably bad for you.
What you can't afford?
That's why I'm not going to call you stupid.
What you can't afford? What?
Like, a lot of big problems with the food is that people are poor and they can't afford to go. They don't even have nice markets in their area. They can't go buy.
But they do have food choices. And if they stop buying stuff with 600% milligrams of salt and sodium.
But a lot of organic stuff is marketed simply higher.
I think with two of them, you should go there.
Depends on where you shop.
Yeah, depends
now
on where
Now at Ralph's,
shop.
They have a lot of organic sales. The everyday thing is,
no,
Ralph's isn't this.
In LA, there's like a radius of like miles and miles where there won't be a supermarket.
Then get off your ass and walk to Holmes. Get some organic shit going.
You have to wake up at 7:30. You go to work. You come back at 6:00.
You know what? You just gave me an idea.
You have to go
there's
to
always
kids.
Excuses. How do you get the excuses out of the way of your success?
They're not necessarily excuses, they're choices. So if you choose to do stuff, it's a very valid way of doing it, but is it really your preferred way of doing things? You have to look into yourself. Do I prefer to eat a hot dog or eat a bunch of fruits and vegetables? I wonder what's gonna make me feel better. Am I gonna feel more preferable by eating a hot dog, or am I going to prefer to feel what I feel after eating fruits and vegetables? That's the choice you have to make. It's not an excuse. It's a preference.
So in line with that preference concept, if people are anesthetized, and today you're a number of many billions, how do you get out of the anesthesia that we've gotten people into? They're robots now. They go to work, they watch television, they see who got shot, we gossip, we shit, we're done.
The human slave force.
Thank you. It's no longer slaves, because we call it workforce, but it is right. Slavery. We just don't have to house them and give them medical anymore.
No problem. This is going to be an answer that everyone's going to hate me for. But I'll do it.
Go for it.
All right. The world needs slaves. We need slaves, because in order for real lives to exist, people have to work for the real lives. So, but that's necessarily a bad thing, you know, in the sense that everything exists and there's polarity in the universe. We need to use the negative to be able to influence and feel positive. And in order for us to do that, we have to wield the negative. So we have to wield all the depressed and stupid people out there so the really strong and intelligent people can thrive. That's
so
why the workforce exists.
Would the slaves be also like the little dying people in Africa that live in the places where the forests are being cut down? Because they don't have any control over that. It's like it's so Europeanized. And like Africa was just like left out in the whole process that they just became slaves.
I'll take that. So, okay, in a sense, there's just two opposites, right? In the universe, you have a black hole and you have a star. Just like in the human species, you have a king and you have a slave. In order for you to have that proper polarity to be able to experience every aspect of the reality that you're in, need to have an example of what you don't want to be. And if existence and consciousness manifests a person starving in Africa, and makes you understand what is possible so you can understand better yourself in comparison.
Go ahead. You have a new director for a minute.
Cool.
what do you think about like all the storms and stuff that are going on? Like how are those being brought in by environmental changes, like Hurricane Patricia down in Mexico and all these other global changes?
The discussion on global warming and the discussion on weather changing is a distraction on the actual problem. The more we talk about the actual problem, the problems of the weather and the problems of things that we can't control, it's a trip for our own minds to actually be distracted on the things that we really need to focus on. And the things we really need to focus on is yourself. There's nothing else that matters. You focus on yourself and you improve your ability to harness your own capabilities and be the best that you can be, positively and accurately, then you'll be able to influence the rest of the world in a bigger way. In fact, you might even be able to influence the biggest influencers, which is the rulers of our planet, in a way for them to make enough change where we think they think that we're ready to not experience those type of things. And if we're gonna actually fight the unfightable, fight the weather, are you gonna fight the weather, you're gonna fight the food, you're gonna fight, no, you're not. You're just fighting yourself. You're gonna get angry and that's gonna create negative emotions. You might get fucking cancer. So stop worrying about it, relax, maybe eat some food, and chill out.
Who are the rulers of the planet?
Not gonna discuss that.
Good outtake.
Did we do like the
violet? But I guess instead of saying who are the rulers of the planet, is there an influence in this? Basically, there's a situation here that we're all dealing with this subject of this project, and that is the deforestation of rainforest, right?
Right.
There's some who say, you know, it's government fault in these countries for letting it happen. Some who say it's corporate infrastructure, you get the money. Some would say it's just pure ignorance. What I guess I'm saying is like, are these the rulers of the planet? Because most people think the rulers of the planet, and I'm not saying talk about the rulers of the planet. I'm talking about who are the people that are actually doing things to get us in this state.
Now I actually have to get into metaphysics. There's no way I can get aboard it. So the ruler of the planet, honestly, if you really want me to go to it, is yourself. You are the ruler of the planet. You're the only person that actually influences everything around you. No one else does. It's irrelevant. What everyone else does is irrelevant, honestly. What you do is relevant. So stop being influenced by other things that are around you. Stop being influenced by circumstances. Stop being influenced by other people's actions. Influence yourself.
I'm in a studio recording.
Jackie, you want chocolate?
Shit to everyone else.
I can try.
Okay.
I don't know how good I'll be.
That's all right. You'll be fine. Looking for different perspectives.
Definitely probably have different perspectives than him. I don't know what you're talking about.
Can we put the two of you up there together, like going back and forth?
Yeah, I'll tune it for you.
Okay.
Do you want to keep going or you feel good?
I don't know. How was that?
It was good. I think it'd be funny if the two of you were up there together.
Just do a little bit of it.
It's like you guys like looking together at the camera.
Our views are really fucking like different.
Okay. That's why it might be interesting.
Yeah.
It's like it could be a, like sure looking at you, you saying
really
something
some
back
shit,
and forth.
In my actual
Let's just
base,
try it.
Like
if it doesn't work,
really
if it doesn't work, it's just an outtake.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right.
You'd be like, "This is my 18-year-old girlfriend."
No, you're not.
I focus on myself, so this is what you get.
This is my girlfriend. She just came from high school, and yes.
My name is Jackie Vinay, JACQIVENE with an accent over the T.
Isn't she cute?
Okay, so we're here to talk about global warming, right?
Sure. Yeah.
Okay. So, one of the things that I learned was that 121 prescriptions.
Social studies.
No, I don't even know where I learned it. But 121 prescription drugs are currently used from plant-based products or like from plants. And also just thinking about like how many Chinese Asian remedies that are so good for you that are like derived from herbal medications that we still use today that are, I think, the best way to like cure so many different things like teas and whatnot, just come from plants. And the fact that we're like even considering just like going past this idea of destroying so much plant life is crazy, because it helps. It's not just like a breathing thing. It's not just like some outside thing that we don't see. It's like every day it affects us. Plants do. Like so much more than we can even like fathom.
This is a good idea. She has lots of facts. She used to memorize things every day.
What do you
mean?
She
had to do this. School didn't do this for you, right?
Yeah, you went to school?
I did it.
Everyone memorizes things every day.
Schools were stupid.
True, that's why I'm not
going to
college.
Oh my god, he's so smart. And then also, all those facts are great. You know, there's a lot of ways to stay healthy. In fact, actually, the best way to stay healthy, I think, is to do things, to not do the things that are unhealthy. Like, you know, eating lots of really, like, cooked, hard meats.
Okay, yeah, but some people are
that,
uneducated, so like, and we can't help that, and us talking about that isn't going to help the huge percentage of people that don't know. So what we should talk about is how we, the stronger people that know about this stuff, can get that out to people that don't know it.
Yeah.
You know? No, it's true. Like, that's what's important, is because we have to decide is like either being selfish and like just pushing forward as being strong and knowledgeable, like we know, so the other people suffer, or we can spread the knowledge and power within everybody else and help everyone come together. Like you were saying, like, you're the ruler, you do what you have to do, but do not believe in helping others. Like, not in that terrible way of saying
there,
it, debate, but
of course,
like,
there's actually, yeah, I understand that. Yeah. When I say that you're in control of knowledge and choosing things that are influencing, other people influence you in the sense that you're influencing them first. First you influence them, then they influence you. So in a sense, you're still influencing yourself. But if somebody is coming to you in a way where you think that they're in trouble, it's influencing you to influence them more than anything else. But if you don't feel bad about it, because if it does, if you do it and you're doing cause to your harm to yourself, or by going out of your way and helping someone else, then you're doing something irresponsibility.
But sometimes I feel like that mindset is what leads us here, because it's like you're in this mindset of like, I'm the only person that matters, so you're not even thinking about any of the effects of anyone else or anything that's happening. You're just like, me, what I need, what I want. And so it's like, use, what's in front of me, whatever I can get, I'm like,
well,
not caring.
See, that's the, yes, I understand what you mean, like the three-dimensional view on understanding doing whatever is best for yourself. Is that, but in the sense of being healthy, there is nothing more important. And being healthy actually is good for the environment too.
But like, what if you don't have the option to be healthy?
Then
like the kids in Africa who don't have clean water.
I think they should shoot themselves.
No,
they should
really,
probably
like,
put themselves out of their misery immediately. They're in like a torture chamber right now. They don't understand how the universe works. They're
they
scared.
Don't. So
they're
you
scared.
Don't. You don't think that like the people who have the power to help them should?
No, because they need to exist. The sovereign people in Africa have to exist because there is an existence for them. Now, in order for you to be able to shift your vibration to a point where they don't exist, is up to you.
So do you think, like, the deforestation has to exist for us to help it?
The better you get, the better the forest gets.
But, like, think about the kids 40, 50 years from now who would watch this and see some jackass point at the camera
If kids 40, 50 years from now see this,
eat your power drink, and everything will be fine.
Kids 40 to 50 years see this,
that means we made it.
A boat. A vital boat. How's that?
Okay.
Big boat.
We won't even travel now.
Could you guys talk about just specifically the, what was the forest?
Yeah, so you
agree
with the tagline?
But yeah.
Okay, so it's Morales Rainforest Should Not Die.com for the website.
Just like, yeah, check out Morales Rainforest.com.
Yeah.
Say it. Morales Rainforest.
Morales Rainforest Don't Die.
Moradus rainforest.
So Moradus rainforest should not die.
Should not die.
And then like talk a little bit about what was it.
Well, you can say what you would find out about the film, like ways you can help,
okay.
The truth about what's going on with business leaders hiding the facts, how rapidly trees are being destroyed, and kind of what you would pitch to the kind of family members. Like, this is a film that I'm involved with. More information is at Moradus Rainforest Should Not Die.com. And this is why I'm passionate about it.
Do you guys put the photo of yourself forward?
www.moradusrainforest.com.
No!
Check it out.
Moradus Rainforest Should Not Die.
Moradus Rainforest Should Not Die.
You should go there because I know it's scary to go and, like, actually
think. Hold on, can we step that over?
Okay, to learn more about what we're talking about and why it's such an important deal and why so many important people are spending days and days and days, years of their time devoted to this subject, you should go to moradusrainforestshouldnotdie.com. And I know it's scary to kind of really come face to face with what's actually happening, but it's not as scary as what could happen if you don't.
What do you think, Blake?
Go to the website, check it out, and don't pay any attention to it. And then go to my website at edmtv.com. I'm just kidding. Go to the website, it's better.
I think we did have to. He wasn't on the show, so I told him any more calls, after
let's
six,
one,
no more interruptions for the rest of the time.
Get up here.
What's up here?
What are we doing?
We're taking a picture.
He's such a big boy.
We call him Butch in the yard.
Aww.
Yes, because he's a quicker, bigger upper.
Pretend like they're rainforest trees.
Kelly, stop.
He smells like one.
You
put me out of the gym.
Yeah, and then you were sitting here bench pressing trying to show booby lady.
My boobs. Here, give me this picture.
I'm sure you now.
Because you smell much better.
We need someone good looking in here.
Well, no, you don't.
I'll leave you.
I don't, thank you. I took a shower today.
You still smell
like a sugar. Oh, ouch, okay. Well, you smell like a strawberry. What is that you have on?
It's just me.
Does your sister smell like that?
Tell
your sister to bring the berry smell. It's very good. Smile. You want a picture with this guy?
Wait.
Or anybody else on set?
Sure.
Jump in. Come on, let's have some quick fun. Quick
we
got to
get her alone.
We got to get her alone. Okay, we're going to get you alone. Get on stage, I'm going to get you alone. And I'm going to have fun with this. So what you have to do is spell your name, say your name, spell your name, and then what title you want with your name. Like actress, singer, humanitarian, dog catcher.
What should be my title?
Girlfriend,
what do you want
know you as? What are
Matt's
you?
Matt's girl.
What are you, just hot chick? Hot mama? What would you
no,
want?
I'm much more than that.
Yeah, what would you, if people were to describe you, what would they call you?
What if people
describe you? That's
18-year-old girlfriend. What do you want to be known as? Let's go there.
Is that stupid?
No. fantastic. For health and wellness.
Health and wellness.
Yeah, health and wellness.
Just do me a favor and stay on that mark.
Okay.
So, your name, spell it, and then the title, or titles. And light it up.
It's harder to be yourself than it is to like.
Yeah, it is.
That's true.
Yeah, because you're not rehearsing a script. You're not putting yourself into a script. You're actually having to be vulnerable. You're having to be real. Ooh, something people have a lot of fucking problems doing in this town. Get raw.
Well, because Matt's gonna make fun of me the whole time.
Who's gonna do?
Maybe we need
to. We'll kick him off the set if he's a problem. Come on, light it up.
Throw a sheet over.
He likes that. Time to the bedpost. A beautiful oblivion. Sorry. Rendezvous with you. I'm sorry. Now the song's racing in my head. Yes, your name is.
Oh, exciting? Okay.
We did that a week ago.
Okay,
we're going to catch
up.
We've been rolling this whole fucking time. The outtakes we're going to have are fucking great. We're in great bloopers. Oh, now, hold on. Get it a little more like this.
Is it okay?
I don't know.
My name is Jackie Vinay, JACQIVENE with an accent over the E, and I am an advocate for health and wellness.
So why are you an advocate for health and wellness? Individuals have a responsibility to the greater whole to start demanding better. Yeah, you're talking to the camera at all times.
Okay.
You're not looking at anyone else in the room. This is your person.
Okay.
That's all you have to pay attention to. So, do we have a responsibility as individuals to help one another heal ourselves and the planet?
Repeat that beginning.
In the beginning, there were small farm animals running through the streets screaming, "What a friend we have in Jesus." When they got done with that, they asked, "Do we have a responsibility to help one another heal as well as the planet?"
I personally do. I know others would not agree with me, but I feel very blessed being able to live in America.
Stop a half a sec. I want you to let your body free. Stop picking at your fingers and wanting to pick your nose. And I want you to pretend this is your best friend, your lover, because if you don't win this over, you've lost the game.
Always move
okay, and then when you talk, you're kind of like this right now, and you kind of look like the girl in the corner that's about to do something weird. Okay, try it again from the top.
Okay.
Do we have a responsibility to heal ourselves and others?
Yeah, I do think that we have a responsibility to heal ourselves and others because a lot of people don't know what it's like to see or be with people that aren't in our same circumstances. It's really easy to like just dismiss it and avoid the subject completely when you live in a nice house and you have no question where you're going to go to bed, or like you can just get up and drink some water or go buy a sandwich the next morning, and it's really easy to just switch the channel from breaking news of what's happening in Syria and all these other countries, because we can just one click and it's done. That if you like read into it or spend any time or like went there, and just imagine not having the choice of being born into that situation. Like, I can't even fathom what it would be like if I didn't have my simple, menial life decisions that I think are so important and so hard. Like, what color to paint my nails? Instead, like, wow, I don't know where I should go to not get shot this morning.
Do you realize you're the first generation that's life expectancy may range from 2 to 25?
No.
You know why that is? Give me your best one. And I did say 2 to 25, not 225. Age 2 to age 25.
Well, probably has to do with
naivety,
of whatever it is, health of our planet, and then maybe warm conflict.
A lot of those are correct. It's because of global warming, extinction, and it's a planet raises by 1 degree.
and they've known about this for 50 years, so your forefathers, grandfathers, uncles, relatives, people of our recent generations made a decision to sell us out, thinking we'd have it fixed when it was our turn, but they devastated so badly, you may never get it.
How would you?
Well, it's devastating, and it's like a tearing rage just thinking about it. But it's empowering to have that knowledge. We as this generation have so much power with Google and with everything that we have, so much knowledge just at our fingertips that we can find out. And now we're finding it out. So I don't think that it stops here with the devastation and whatever it is that it causes in everybody. And I don't think that there's an end, and I don't think that we're seeing a finish line. I think that we have a long way to go. I don't think that particularly easy is like digging our grave, but I think it could, because a lot of people just continue to not choose not to.
What can someone who doesn't have a lot of power, doesn't have a lot of self-confidence, feels kind of weak and insecure, how can they feel step out of your shell and be part of the solution? We can all be angry about what went wrong. That doesn't fix it. So now we got to get positive. And what's the solution? How do we get proactive and not reactive?
I guess it all starts with realizing yourself, self-worth. And that comes to just simple tasks of finding what you love in life. And for me, that has a lot to do with nature, and I'm not just saying that. Like, I could be really sad, but go out in like a field of flowers and it's the most beautiful thing ever. And you realize that you really aren't that important, but everything else around you, I don't know, is just, I don't know, what was the question?
Yeah, actually did well.
Rainforests give us 40% of our air. 25-30% of food, water, medicine, minerals, things that end up in our everyday life. But there are certain things we can live without. Almost deeply. And we're destroying the rainforest so fast. Only discovered 1% of its benefit. That means 99% is still to be explored. But we're chopping it down faster than we can explore. What's the solution?
The solution is knowledge, is knowing this, is spreading the information, but not only that, then literally just stop using it. It's not as hard as it sounds. Like, my dad will always be like, oh, well, it's really hard to find all the organic things. They're a little more expensive. You just have to choose your worth, and you have to write all these things down of the person that you want to be and become it. You have to take that step, and you have to help others take that step by being an example. Because once they see that someone just like themselves is able to do it, they'll want to do it. And it has to do with majority, because people are all, they're creatures of habit, which is why once they get into this habit of name brand, it's so easy for these companies to just monopolize and like suck you in and just put a little happy picture on their box and you'll buy it. But when it comes down to it, the more people that start doing it, it'll all happen. It's just, we're at this crucial point where we have to get there. Just everyone to start doing it. It's the hardest thing to think about, but it's not that it's simple.